President Joseph Estrada enjoyed huge popularity at the start of his term. Then came the corruption scandals that led to the end of his presidency. This report. President Joseph Estrada, the 13th president of the Philippines, served just 935 days, or less than 3 years, one of the shortest terms in the country's presidential history.
Walang kaibigan! Walang kumpare! Walang kamag-anak o anak na maaaring magsamantala ngayon!
He had been a popular president, with almost 11 million Filipinos voting into office in 1998 and giving him the biggest margin of victory ever in the country's electoral history. But in October 2000, presidential buddy Ilocos Sur Governor Luis Chavit Singson linked Estrada and his family to huweting, an illegal numbers game. That accusation sparked impeachment proceedings against Estrada, initiated by then Speaker Manuel Villar in the House. Senators eventually acting as judges in the impeachment court. And then Supreme Court Chief Justice Hilario Davide Jr. sitting as presiding officer. The trial began December 7, 2000, was the first time a Philippine president faced possible impeachment. Estrada was accused of bribery, graft and corruption, betrayal of public trust, and culpable violation of the Constitution. Millions of Filipinos watched the day-to-day trial covered live on television. Among the trial highlights was the testimony of then-bank official Clarissa Ocampo, who said she was a foot away when Estrada signed the name Jose Velarde in documents that involved a 500 million peso investment. The trial ended abruptly on January 16, 2001, when prosecutors walked out of the proceedings after Estrada senator allies voted against opening an envelope that supposedly contained incriminating evidence against him. Senator Aquilino Pimentel Jr. resigned as Senate president after the vote and joined the walkout along with 9 opposition senators. It resulted in the Second People Power Revolution, or EDSA 2. For 4 days, hundreds of thousands of Filipinos rallied in EDSA to call for Estrada's resignation. On January 19, police and military forces withdrew their support from Estrada. At around noon on January 20, Davide swore Estrada's constitutional successor, Vice President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, into office. A few hours later, Estrada and his family fled Malacañang. In April 2001, when Estrada was arrested, his supporters protested and massed up in what would be called EDSA 3 or EDSA 3, which lasted nearly 4 days. He was under house arrest until September 2007, when the Sandigan Bayan found him guilty of plunder, a capital offense. The anti-graft court jailed Estrada for life, but allowed him to remain under house arrest pending his appeal. More than a month after his guilty verdict, Arroyo granted him pardon.